Laura, hi.
You startled me. Don't sneak up on a person like that, huh?
Sorry, I'm looking for Braxton. Have you seen him?
Braxton? I've never even heard of a Braxton. Got nothing for you, sorry.
Let me guess, this is his apartment. I really need to get my medical up. Relax, no one's in trouble. I'm just looking to have a friendly chat with him.
Oh, in that case, he told me he was delivering to this house in the ruins south of town. Whole family had fallen sick, and he had some meds on hand.
Oh.
So maybe look for him there?
Maybe that's why he hasn't shown up for a while. He's been unavoidably detained by whatever or whoever he encountered at the ruins. All right, well, that's all I needed.
Reminder, if you let your SAM unit be eaten by wildlife, it voids the warranty.
I'm not going to let you be eaten, Sam. I guess maybe he lives with her. I don't know. Oh, wait. Out for deliveries. Dropping a care package off with the Mathers in the old ruins south of Stellar Bay. Be back soon. Laura, I know you're reading this. Stay out of my things. Why are you going in his things? That's my job.
Everything's spinning. I'm just gonna take it easy, okay?
Testing this. It's not her place anyway. But thinking maybe because her back's turned, she won't see me going into things. Yeah, she don't care. Doesn't seem like you'd need ammo anyway. Well, that's that for the apartments. Looks like somebody just put a big plate there on the wall. So finish exploring, and then we gotta go back to that toss ball betting place. Talmadge?
The body's in the first apartment on the right.
Oh, yeah.
So much blood.
Yeah, I saw. Oh, it's dark back here. There's a workbench back there? Zeng's Emporium. Zeng's to-do list. Clean dead mantis swarms from air filters. Purchase gaskets. Do not buy from Sebastian again. Those looked like they'd been sitting in a rat's belly. Get fish oil from Vilma. Ask Catherine for a resupply. Bother Sanjar about walls. Okay. Zeng!
Well, well. The only new folk I ever see in town are sublight runners from Fallbrook. But you don't look like one of Catherine's.
It's because I'm not.
What can I get you?
Guess the only thing I can do is trade.
All sales are final, unless you threaten me. I'm kidding. Don't threaten me.
I don't see a reason to. Here, take this. Plasma carbine, though. 156 long guns. I have a lot of guns. Let's get rid of this one. Well, I have a light pistol. I have two light pistols. There we go. Alright, that's it. I don't need to buy anything. I steal most of my things. Wait, did I say that out loud? Really, this is it? You're just an outside... It's like a stall. I'm like a market stall. Oh, that's Sebastian's. Oh. He has a wildlife emporium.
Got any news from the rest of...
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Guy's mouth is moving, but he's not saying anything.
Rat musk and canid eyes, right here.
Canid eyes?
Hello, stranger. Can I interest you in raptodon tongue? Or maybe some canid toenails?
Not really.
You look like a woman who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts.
Why would I want any of that?
I don't know. Celia usually buys whatever I have, and Mr. Pickett seemed real interested. So I thought maybe I was onto something.
Huh.
Mr. Pickett? Franklin Pickett from Edgewater?
Oh, really?
That's him. He'd been here years, but he always talked about going back to Edgewater one day.
Parvati, you know who he's talking about?
Sure. Mr. Pickett used to run the community center outside Edgewater. He had this grand idea to make it a museum for Halcyon life. As my dad told it, Mr. Pickett was always going on about getting a manta queen for the last display. He left the Vale, gosh, years ago.
He came to Stellar Bay years ago, just before the board cut us off. Ended up stuck here. He was always real interested in our monsters. Manta queens, especially.
Oh, right, the community center with that display of all those animals, and the manta queen wasn't finished. Have you seen a manta queen?
Sure. They're real big. Hard to miss them.
Where have you seen the manta queen?
Well, I could send you to the same place I sent Mr. Pickett. But I haven't seen him in a few weeks. To tell true, I'm starting to get a bit worried about him.
Captain, can we look for him?
Yeah.
I'd feel awful if somebody from home was in trouble and we didn't do nothing.
Tell you what. I'll tell you where I sent Mr. Pickett if you promise to look for him. Help him out if he's got himself in trouble. Fair deal?
Yeah, I'm not real pleased about going up against a manta queen, but, if he's a friend of Parvati's, I suppose I oughta.
Thanks, Captain.
No problem.
All right, then. Leave town through the southern gate, the one right here, and head past the abandoned ruins. Last manta queen I saw was in the wilds out that-a-ways. Could be Mr. Pickett still out there, too.
About Mr. Pickett.
Yeah. You find him yet?
Where shall I look for him? Can you tell me anything more specific?
I sent him past the ruins just south of town. He was hunting for a manta queen out there.
Alright, well, let's talk about Celia.
Huh. I haven't seen her in a few days. But I've been meaning to ask her how that raptodon acid is working out. I hope it's working okay, because no one else really seems interested in this stuff.
Well, she likes you.
Nice of you to say. I like her, too.
No, I mean, she really likes you.
And I gotta admire anyone with her passion for canid hides. But you don't have to butter me up.
You idiot. I'm trying to tell you she wants to date you.
Wait, I see what's going on. She put you up to this so she could get a discount,
Oh, no, that's not it at all. She's smitten with you. You smited her.
Smited her.
Smoke?
She's awesome.
Don't get me wrong. I'd like to give her a discount. She's a real fine lady. Always talks nice and slow, so I understand.
Oh, God.
But if I give her one, I won't hardly make a bit. On account of no one else having any use for raptodon tongues.
She doesn't want a discount. She's attracted to you.
Nuh-uh. A lot of people think I'm not too bright, but you're not fooling me. I know she can't get these goods anywhere else.
You're the most naive person I've ever met, or you have a very low self-esteem. I'm tempted to take the persuade, but I'm curious about how far down the rabbit hole we can go until we convince him otherwise. You think she needs the stuff she buys? She just wants an excuse to talk to you.
Come on, that's crazy. No one would do that.
All right. Don't take my word for it. Spend some time with her. I promise she won't ask for a discount.
You sound pretty sure. And she is awful nice.
Give her a chance. Give yourself a chance. Take her someplace nice.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll do it. Once her shift ends, we'll go someplace nice. Maybe to Chef Raymond's.
That's the spirit, Sebastian. Be yourself. Between you and me, Captain, I'm not sure Miss Celia knows him too well. But we can hope, right?
I want them to be happy.
Yeah, miracles happen.
You look like a woman who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts.
Yeah, just out of curiosity, what do you have? Animal parts. Organic cysty pig tumors. They're literally falling off the backs of cysty pigs passing by. Just flick the dirt off and they're ready to eat. No cysty pigs are harmed in production of this food. Ugh. Mantiplasma gland. A plasma-infused gland from a mantisaur. I am sure this plasma gland will be useful to someone, somewhere, but I'm not sure who or what for. I'd just sell it. Is this Sebastian's words? Raptodon flank hide. The softer flank hide of a raptodon harvested from a kill. What Celeste wants with this is anyone's guess. Manta queen chitin. A piece of chitin taken from a manta queen. The carapace of a manta queen is flexible and pliant, yet strong enough to resist gunfire. I'm really not looking forward to fighting those things. Raptodon meat. A lumpy slice of fresh raptodon. Oh yeah, I've seen this. Enthusiastic local gourmands have compared the flavor to select cuts of woolly cow meat. Yeah, I do actually have some of this stuff. Can you repair a cysty pig tumor? Don't answer that question. Okay, so Sandra's right in there. We've been there. We've come pretty much full circle here.
Please, will someone help me? My boy's in trouble.
Agnes?
Oh, thank you for stopping. Everyone acts like nothing's wrong. Like my little boy isn't at risk of being eaten by some vile creature.
What?
Please, you have to help me get my little Tucker back. He ran away and is going to get himself killed. Oh, I just know a raptodon is melting him with acid as we speak.
Wow, so much for having hope. Your child is missing? Where'd you last see him?
Oh, I just knew you were a good person.
You're weird
Agnes,
looking.
Agnes, I said, this is the woman to save your little ducky.
Ducky?
And I was right. He ran out into the wilderness a few days ago. I warned him about the raptodons, mantisaurs and marauders, the toxic sulfur pools and poisonous plants, but he didn't listen.
Oh, law, Captain. A youngster won't last long in a place like this. Please, can't we help?
Please, won't you go and find my boy?
Why would Tucker run away?
He's been pining for an adventure. Says he's tired of living cooped up behind the walls. But he doesn't understand how dangerous it is out there. I warned him. A raptodon would snap him up first chance of gone. I just know one's ripped his arm off and is gnawing on his sweet little fingers.
Oh my God.
He should have listened to his mama. I promised I'd keep him safe here with me.
You have a pretty sick imagination. Where would he have gone?
He's been listening to those awful broadcasts that the iconoclasts put out. I begged Sanjar to put a stop to them, but did he? No! And now I just know my boy's run off to Amber Heights. That is, if a manta queen hasn't spooled out and eaten his entrails for breakfast already!
Okay, what are you saying about the iconoclasts?
Those low-life degenerates, leading innocent boys into a life of danger. Oh, they make it sound so exciting, like it's noble to risk it all out there, fighting for the greater good. How noble is it to worry your loved ones? Not at all, I say. But still they preach their sermons of anarchy and rebellion to anyone who'll listen. Hmm. If they weren't holed up in Amber Heights, I'd knock them all upside the head.
Where is Amber Heights?
That old settlement, southwest of Stellar Bay. I don't know which is worse, the thought of my son shacking up with the nutty iconoclasts. Or that he never made it. Sprats could be nesting in his rotting body alongside the road as we speak. Or maybe marauders got him, pulled all his teeth out, crushed him into their drugs and made him snort him.
What?
Oh, the things that could happen to my sweet baby.
You seem like you enjoy thinking up all these various ways that your kid could have died. You okay in the head? Did you mention that there was a reward involved with this request?
Well, I guess I can't ask you to leave the town walls for free. It is deathly dangerous out there.
Hell yeah.
I got some bits saved up for a rainy day. I'll give you every last one if you just bring my Tucker back to me. I won't even be mad at him running off. You tell him I won't be mad.
All right. I'll help you find your son. Just stop describing ways in which he could be dying or being tortured horribly, thank you.
Thank you. Oh, I know he'll be safe now that someone's able to fetch him home. You look for him in Amber Heights, you hear? It's down the road southwest of town. I'm sure he made it that far. I just know it.
Okay.
And if you find any of them iconoclasts indoctrinating my boy, you punch them in the mouths.
Specifically,
tell them what I think
mouths?
Of them luring little boys away from their mamas. It's immoral.
Okay. All right, and then that's the way out. Have I been back here?
Keep him quiet, Cap.
Okay. Yeah, that was pretty disturbing, all the things. How could you say that about your kid? I am not talking to her.
Who's the sweetest boy? Who is it?
Error. Unable to process the specific customer service request. Please repeat the order.
Yeah, you are.
I love it. Oh my god. That was awesome. Alright, so we've got another quest. Sebastian has agreed to give things a chance with Celia. Go tell her. Mr. Pickett went looking for a manta queen. Sebastian hasn't seen him since. He's worried the man may be in trouble. Sebastian sent Mr. Pickett to the wilderness southwest of Stella Bay to find a manta queen. Search the area for signs of Mr. Pickett. Right, the victim had a betting slip from left field toss ball betting. Perhaps someone there knows what happened to him. Where's the quest for the kid? Tucker. Oh, I selected this instead. Tucker Needham ran away from Stellar Bay a few weeks ago to join the iconoclasts in Amber Heights. His mother Agnes is willing to pay handsomely if you can locate her son and convince him to return. Amber Heights is a settlement that houses the iconoclasts on Monarch. If Tucker Needham survives his travels, his mother thinks he'll be there. Alright, let's go talk to Celia. Who is, yeah, right in here, of course. Well, good news.
Have you talked to Sebastian yet? What did he say?
He said he'll go on a date with you.
Okay, but how did he say it? Did he sound excited? Or like he was just agreeing to it? Was he like, yay, a date with Celia? I've secretly been waiting for this. Or was it more, sure, I don't have anything else going on.
He likes you, Celia. Just don't ask him for any discounts.
Not to worry. If I never buy another Raptodon tongue, it'll be too soon. look at me going on. I'm sure you've got other things to do, and Mr. Nandi's giving me that back-to-work look. Anyhow, thank you.
Oh, money. You're very welcome, and thank you.
As you were.
Okay, I guess that's complete. Amber Heights. Okay, back left field toss ball batting now. I don't know if I can pass through here. I probably can. But let's just go around. Excuse me. It's around back. Oh. Hello again.
Here to catch a game? I'm afraid the transmission's still pretty bad.
No.
What can I do for you?
I found this betting slip in a dead man's apartment. Any idea what might have happened to him?
Poor Isaac. I was wondering why I hadn't seen him in a few days.
Well, so you know him.
I'd really like to help. Isaac was a sweet fellow, even if he did have terrible teeth.
What do his teeth have to do with anything?
They were pretty distinct. Monarch doesn't exactly have a thriving dental industry, and Isaac seemed to get stuck in all sorts of bad habits, dietary and otherwise. Sometimes he'd drink purpleberry punch by the liter, other times he'd keep betting on a losing team, started owing the wrong people money.
So who did he owe?
I don't know for sure, but I saw Elijah and his buddies pushing Isaac around. They're hooligans from Fallbrook. They sweep into town, drop supplies off behind the warehouse, and spend the rest of their stay getting rowdy over tossball games. They usually loiter in the alley behind the yacht club. They're not allowed in the bar anymore. I bet you anything Isaac ran into trouble with one of them.
Thanks for the tip.
Mr. Sanjar will be pleased to hear about it when you're done. I know he gets fed up with the Fallbrook bullies, but there's not much he can do.
Investigate Elijah and his gang. Nell believes Elijah and his friends killed Isaac. They make deliveries to the bays behind the warehouse and spend the rest of their time in the alley behind the yacht club. Alright. Potential fisticuffs?
I hear those rich people in Byzantium pay a handsome bit for rat musk.
Bet they also pay to make it stink less.
Supposedly it makes you more attractive for, you know.
Trust me, no one's going near you like this.
Haha. The alley behind the yacht club, okay. Have I even...
You ever think about what goes on in a marauder's head?
No, they're crazy.
But they still manage to feed themselves, dress themselves, work together. Gotta be something to that.
All I need to know is that they're on the other side of that wall.
I'm sure someone said the same thing in Amber Heights.
I gotta find a new drinking buddy.
Yeah, you guys don't really have a chemistry for conversing. Alley behind the yacht club.
Whoops, hold on there, Sam. I think you got some schmutz on your chassis.
Did your SAM unit get dirty on the job? Simply initiate SAM self-cleaning mode. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3.
Nuh-uh. You keep that nozzle to your own self.
I think that's what he meant. He was gonna clean himself.
You look like a woman who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts.
Good luck on that date. Back there. We were just back there, weren't we? It's gonna get ugly, isn't it?
Beat it.
Who the fuck are you? This ain't your alley.
I am. What do you have to say?
Beat it.
No one wants to be defeated. Hi.
Hey, what are you doing here? This is our secret alley.
Ain't no secret anymore.
Murda already pissed by those crates to market.
I know you murdered Isaac.
Listen, that purple tooth twerp had it coming. Not that anyone has proof. And not that it's any of your business.
I'm making it my business, mister.
Oh yeah? What are you saying exactly?
You've bullied people long enough. If you know what's good for you, you clear out. Never come back.
Wow. Most of the pencil pushers around here cave as soon as you look at them funny. Fine. We're going. This ain't worth it.
Shouldn't they be brought to justice? We're just gonna let them leave?
Beat it.
Whatever. It's not like I knew the guy. Plus we got guards right there. I don't want to get in a fight with them as well. Sandra will want to know about Isaac's murder. Now that you've dealt with Elijah, check in with him at MSI headquarters. Alright. Yeah, we'll go back to Sanjar, however you say it. Hello.
A fine day for business, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Anyway, what can I do for you?
Monkey business. Business. Killing is my business, and business is good. Well, it's, yeah, I didn't kill him, but Isaac Rose is dead. I found the people who killed him.
But that's terrible. What happened?
It was Elijah and his hooligan friends. Hooligans. I don't think I've ever called anyone a hooligan. At least not in a serious manner. I ran them out of town.
I'm glad to hear you've dealt with them. They've been causing quite a bit of trouble around town. I've been consumed with other matters of late, but I would have dealt with them. Eventually.
Well, of course you would have.
Of course I would have.
That's what Still, I said.
Your intervention in the matter is much appreciated.
Sweet.
Please consider this payment for your services.
Why, thank you. Oh. Still get a rush every time I hear that. Well, let me just get rid of this. Boop, 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 boop. What do I keep wanting better? Medical? Let's do all that this time. It's better now. I'm not sure how much time I have, but what I wanted to do is increase these all to 50 like I have here, and then individually go up, like, I'd probably go more persuade and intimidate, not so much lie. And here I'd go more dodge, less block. I'd probably go more medical, less science engineering. And I'd probably just make these equally, and then we have to keep up with sneaking, hacking, and I guess to a lesser point, lockpick. Actually, you lockpick a lot more than hack. Alright. Anything else to do here in town?
Everything about death, Sam?
You won't find a more highly effective nor highly efficient auto-mechanical fine-tuned to neutralize noxious contaminants on Halcyon's market. SAM units are reliably certified at killing filth dead.
We gotta be put in this universe to do more and kill. We got to,
mister. Okay, I'm not going to give her this yet, because I'm not ready to leave, unless that's the last thing. Yeah, that's far away, so secret people. South, this is all outside. This, I want to... Braxton. Is she the one looking for Braxton? Yeah, right? So if I find Braxton, then I'll come back and negotiate with her. Where's Fallbrook? I don't think we're ready to deal with Amanda Queen. Here's the region. There's our objective. Where are we? We are here. Okay. See, it's not close. But I guess that's it. There's really not much else to do in here. We have to go outside and deal with stuff. But Manta Queen aside, I feel confident. I have Parvati. I have this awesome freaking auto-mechanical robot here. So next episode will be leaving Stellar Bay. Heading southeast. Looking for people. Oh, right. She's going to guide me through. Dr. Williams' body. Let me see. That's like right outside town. I guess she will guide us through the Monarch Wilderness. Will she take us anywhere? To all our objectives? Or she's just gonna stick with us for this? She's gonna bring us to the broker. Well, we have her pills. Right, yeah, we might as well have her with us since it's so tough out there. We'll give her a pills, and that'll be next episode, and we'll be on our way. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.